pilot testing of limited face-to-face classes is set to begin next week. Here to tell us about the Education Department's plans, we have DepEd Undersecretary Nepomuceno Malaluan. Undersecretary Malaluan, good morning.
Yes, good morning, Ms. Karen, and to all of your televiewers.
All right, parents watching right now all want to understand the DepEd's plan. Give us an overview of the pilot face-to-face classes.
Yes, Ms. Karen, the Department of Education is really intent to reintroduce face-to-face classes to address the limitations of distance learning and also to, as part of the government effort to slowly reopen all sectors of the economy. We will be reintroducing face-to-face classes in three phases. And the first phase of that is the pilot phase with a view to expanding it after this pilot phase and onward to the new normal in the future. And to us, the success of the pilot phase is very critical to build confidence that we can do it. And so the Department of Education has worked with the Department of Health to formulate very stringent guidelines to ensure layers of protection for our learners and teachers and all participants of these face-to-face classes. So in a nutshell, that's the plan, Ms. Karen. We are starting with a very small number of schools, just 120 schools.
Yes.
So that we are able to really closely monitor it. But that should be preparatory to an expanded phase with more schools participating. Ms. Karen.
Okay. And these 120 schools, are they all public schools?
This constitute 100 public schools and 20 private schools. The 100, the public schools have already undergone the pre-assessment and as well as the further vetting by the Department of Health on the COVID risk side. But we are just started the process for the selection of the 20 additional private schools, Ms. Karen.
And let's start with the 100 public schools. In what regions are they mostly concentrated in? Is NCR part of the public schools or not yet?
Not yet part of the public schools. The way we did it, Ms. Karen, is that we have 638 pre-assessed schools from the perspective of their readiness to implement the health standards and health protocols. And these 638 schools, where each of the regions are represented, is further evaluated by the Department of Health with respect to the COVID risk standards. So we are dependent on the granular risk assessment by Department of Health. And the first batch of from the 638 that they gave to us is 59 schools. But as I understand, yesterday I've just not seen the list, but there is now an expanded list given by DOH. I'm not sure if NCR is already included, but in the first 59, there is no region in the main island of Luzon that was included, Karen. Mm.
You said there's a new list submitted and there's a possibility that NCR might be included in the public schools list.
I have not checked, but if NCR is included, but in our discussions, if the granular assessment would allow for NCR, then we are prepared to implement in NCR as well.
What about
we had? Yeah,
I'm sorry. What about these 20 private schools? The 20 private schools.
Well, the 20 private schools we have. We are issuing the guidelines or the advisory to them where they can already submit their expression of interest to the regional directors. They have to undergo the same school safety assessment checklist. The agreement with the major private school associations is that they will abide by the joint memorandum circular of the Department of Education and Department of Health.
So I mean, but what
they
areas,
will undergo the same.
Not these 20 schools, what areas? I mean, you've approved 20 private schools.
Not yet approved. There is a process for there is a process, Karen, for their expression of interest. They will submit to the school safety assessment. We have instructed our regional directors to have three private schools nominated each region, and it is from those nominated lists that the Department of Health will undergo the same process of granular risk assessment for COVID-19.
You have international schools appealing that they be considered to be the part of the 20 private schools. What are the chances of that?
Well, we are deliberating right now because they some of them have proactively sent us a plan for their face-to-face classes. And this might not be within the same parameters as what we are doing for the pilot face-to-face classes. So we are deliberating if we will assess them separately, independently of the pilot face-to-face. But that is not a decided matter already. But we will come up with a decision either today or tomorrow on that matter, Ms. Karen.
Mm-hmm. Okay. When is the pilot face-to-face going to start in public schools? I do know that you do have some senators requesting that that the classes be made shorter. I've seen the timetable of the classes, and it seems that face-to-face is alternative days, also alternative weeks. What are you seeing?
Really the face-to-face time or in-person time in schools has really been shortened. For kindergarten, it will just be 3 hours. And for grades 1 to 3, it will only constitute 4 hours. There's really not going to be lunch time within the schools to avoid any further incidents of exposure within the school. And any break time will be a very supervised break time to ensure that physical distancing, ventilation, and all of that are observed throughout the time. In other words, Ms. Karen, the face-to-face activities will not be similar to what we know pre-pandemic. This will be selected activities where there is the greatest benefit from such activities. Ms. Karen, for example, assessment, remediation, the most difficult concepts or learning competencies. So not all of the instruction will be accommodated within that face-to-face sessions, Ms. Karen.
Okay. And the target date to start face-to-face is when? And will there be changes with that?
The first, we anticipate that the actual start for students to come to the school physically as part of the pilot will be on November 15. The pilot has actually started because the pilot includes, after the selection, the preparatory process, such as getting the consent of parents, making the final arrangement with the LGUs, making sure that all systems are in place, some ocular inspection that we will do also from the central region and division offices. So in other words, when the Department of Health has identified some of the schools until we complete the 100, once they are notified, the pilot is already actually running, but the actual classes we anticipate to start on November 15. That's also the All start right. of our third, of our second quarter of the school year.
All right. On that note, Undersecretary Malaluan, I do hope to update with you and speak with you again, sir.
Yes, I hope in better internet connectivity time, Ms. Karen.
I have to agree with you there. Thank you, sir. You take care.
Thank you.